Tom Waits has a very good line to describe the hand-to-mouth road life. He refers to it as out-of-state plates running a little late. To compound that insecurity, my 75 hours of film was scattered around in various garages and attics, alternately freezing and baking over the years. And the idea behind a diary is to preserve the memories, not destroy them. The recession was starting to make itself felt by now, and money for something like a three-screen film is one of the first cutbacks at belt-tightening time. As if to underscore my out-of-step situation, whenever I heard a forgotten tune at noon on the radio, it was invariably one of my favourites. But never let the dough-baits get you down, and just one chance phone call to Oregon set up three bookings, which in turn gave me an opportunity to take my first train trip up the coast to Portland.
Thank you.
It's hard to say quite why it was time to leave America. I think, considering that 12 years ago I'd left on a 2-week holiday, I was beginning to feel like one of those people who pop out for 5 minutes to buy a packet of cigarettes and never come back. I've always associated that act with rain-soaked streets and despair and loss. And there's no reason for me to feel like that. I've got a real nice family.
Pack up all your dishes, make note of all good wishes, and say goodbye to the landlord for me. That son of bitches always bought me. Throw out them L.A. papers and that moldy box of vanilla wafers, and adios to all that concrete. Gonna get me some dirt road back street. If I can just get up on this L.A. freeway without getting killed or called, I'd be down the road in a cloud of smoke to some land I ain't bought before. So it's here to you, oh skinny Dennis. Only one I think I will miss. I can hear that old day singing, sweet and low like a gift you're bringing.
At dawn, my bus was zooming across the Arizona desert, Indio, Blythe, Siloam, the great dry stretches leading to Mexican mountains in the south. Then we swung north to the Arizona mountains, Flagstaff, cliff towns. I had a book with me, but I preferred reading the American landscape as we went along. Every bump, rise, and stretch in it mystified my longing. In inky night, we crossed New Mexico. At gray dawn, it was Dalhart, Texas. In the bleak Sunday afternoon, we rode through one Oklahoma flat town after another. At nightfall, it was Kansas. The bus roared on. I was going home in October. Everybody goes home in October. In the afternoon, we crossed drowsy old Davenport again and the low-lying Mississippi in her sawdust bed. Then Rock Island, a few minutes of traffic, the sun reddening, and sudden sights of lovely little tributary rivers flowing softly among the magic trees and greeneries of mid-American Illinois. It was beginning to look like the soft, sweet East again. The great, dry West was accomplished and done.
And so it's time to leave, not without misgivings. I could be going back to a land of ghosts. So it's hard to know when I'll be back, though I'm sure that I will. Probably when everybody's kids have grown up and it starts all over again.
And Pingaroo Houston, we're satisfied with your pilot for now, and no further data needed. We'd like you to remain airborne for a while.
Will do.